So in the last class, we started with the definition of open channel flow, the difference between open channel flow and pipe flow. Then we moved on to the different types of flows in an open channel. We ended the lecture with the geometrical properties of various cross sections. When I'm talking about the geometrical properties, we discussed about wetted area, wetted perimeter, hydraulic mean radius, hydraulic depth, and the top width. So with that, let us move further. We'll start with this uniform flow in a channel. Kindly recall, in the last class, we defined the uniform flow and a uniform non-uniform flow. If the various physical parameters, such as the depth, velocity, temperature, density, pressure, if these physical parameters, if they do not change all along the reach, then the flow is said to be uniform flow. So this is how we differentiated between uniform flow and non-uniform flow, wherein in non-uniform flow, these various physical parameters, they change from section to section. That's what I mentioned in the bottom of this slide. Uniform flow in an open channel must satisfy the following conditions. The water depth Y, flow area A, I'm talking about wetted area, discharge Q, the velocity distribution V at all sections throughout the entire channel length must remain constant. Then the slope of the bed, the slope of the water surface, and the slope of the energy line. So all these three slopes are parallel to each other. In other words, energy slope is given by SE, water slope is given by S of WS, and that of bed slope is given by S naught. Therefore, S naught is equal to SWS, that is equal to S of E. Now this is possible in case of a uniform flow. I'll come back to this figure once again once we start deriving the equation. Now when you will have this S naught is equal to SWS is equal to SE, this is possible when the gravity force W sin theta, I'll come to that component, is equal to the resistance of flow F of F. Now, in order to derive an equation for a uniform flow, consider a channel having uniform flow. Consider two sections, section 1-1, section 2-2, separated by a distance L. At section 1-1, the pressure force is given by F1 in the direction of flow. At section 2-2, the pressure force is given by F2, which is just opposite to the initial direction F1. Now, the control volume in this case is the boundary between section 1-1 and section 2-2. The weight of water stored between section 1-1 and section 2-2 is given by W. And we know that this W is acting vertically downwards. The bed slope for this uniform channel is given by theta. Now, if I resolve this W in the direction of flow, that becomes W sin theta. Now, what are the forces acting on the control volume? The various forces acting on the control volume are the pressure forces F1 and F2 at both ends, then the self weight of the fluid present in the control volume, that is given by W. If I resolve this W in the direction of flow, that becomes W sin theta. In addition to this, we have another important force. Okay, that force is nothing but the frictional force that is given by F of F. Please refer to this figure. This F of F is always acting opposite to the direction of flow. Kindly recall in the last class, I mentioned that this frictional force is all along the sides. So when I'm talking about the sides, I'm talking about the perimeter. Okay, so with this, let us proceed to derive an equation for this uniform flow. Now, resolving the forces acting on the control volume in the direction of flow and equate it to zero, we have W sin theta, which is acting in the direction of flow, therefore it's a positive sign, plus F1, the pressure force at section 11, again in the direction of flow, minus F2, the pressure force at section 22, which is opposite to the initial direction F1, therefore you have a negative sign, minus the frictional force F of F is equal to zero. Now, since the flow is uniform, the pressure force at section 1 is equal to pressure force at section 2. In other words, F1 is equal to F2. Therefore, you will left with W sin theta is equal to F of F. Now, if the bed slope is very small, then we can write it as sin theta is equal to tan theta is equal to S0. Therefore, the equation becomes W S0 is equal to F of F. Now, we know that this specific weight is equal to weight divided by volume. I am looking for W. W is equal to specific weight into volume. If you consider a control volume, the volume of the control volume is given by, or control section is given by, the area of the control section into the distance between two sections, that is section 11 and section 22, that is given by L. Therefore, this W is equal to gamma into A into L. Therefore, if you substitute this gamma AL in place of W, you are going to get gamma AL S0 is equal to F of F. Now, consider this frictional force F of F. Now, what is this force? Force by area is equal to stress. R. Kindly go back to your third semester fluid mechanics, where we defined this pressure. Pressure is equal to total pressure divided by area. Now, in this case, I want this total pressure. Total pressure is equal to, so pressure into area. If you apply that concept here, the pressure force, or I mean the frictional force, is equal to the shear stress into the area on which it acts. So I told you several times, when I'm talking about the area here, I'm talking about the perimeter or the sides which are in contact with water. That's why I'm talking about P. P into the distance between two sections, 11 and 22, that is given by L. So therefore, F of F can be written as tau naught into P into L. Now, so this tau naught into P into L can be written as R. In other words, we know that this shear stress is directly proportional to the velocity square. I repeat once again, the shear stress is directly proportional to velocity square. I am going to remove this proportionality sign by introducing a constant. Therefore, shear stress is equal to K into V square. In place of tau naught, you are substituting this KV square into PL. Therefore, the equation takes up the form gamma AL S0 on the LHS side, that is equal to KV square into PL on the right hand side. So, tau naught is the resisting force per unit area of the channel, and K is the constant of proportionality. Now, what I am looking for? I am looking for the value of V. So, therefore, V is equal to root of, rearrange the terms, gamma by K into A divided by P into S0. What is gamma? Gamma is the specific weight of water. What is K? K is the constant of proportionality. Therefore, I can write this gamma by K as the constant, and that constant I call it as capital C. And this wetted area divided by wetted perimeter, A divided by P, is nothing but the hydraulic mean radius, that is given by R. Now, if you introduce these terms in the equation takes up the form V is equal to C into root of R into S or S naught. Now V is equal to C into root of R into S naught. This equation is called Chase's formula. What is this C? C is called Chase's constant, and that is given by root of gamma divided by K. And hydraulic mean radius R is given by A divided by P. So Chase's equation, V is equal to C into root of R into S or R into S naught. Okay, I want the discharge. So what is this discharge? Q is equal to A into V, rate of flow. So Q is equal to A into V. So Q is equal to A into, in place of V, you substitute this C into root of RS. Therefore Q is equal to AC into root of RS. So this is how you are going to find the discharge using this Chase's formula. So there are two formulae for finding the uniform flow in an open channel. One is Chase's formula, V is equal to C into root of RS. The other one is Manning's formula. We'll see what is this Manning's formula, how different is this Manning's formula from Chase's formula. So Manning derived an empirical equation based on his experiments, keeping this Chase's equation as the base. What he did was, he replaced this C, the Chase's constant, by 1 over n r to the power of 1 by 6. So what is n? N is Manning's roughness coefficient. Again I repeat, Manning connected the Chase's constant with his constant, that is C is equal to 1 over n r to the power of 1 by 6. Now in Chase's equation, in place of C, if you substitute 1 over n r raised to 1 by 6 and simplify that, you are going to get Manning's formula. So the Manning's formula you are going to get simplifies to V is equal to 1 over n r to the power of 2/3 s to the power of half. Again, n is Manning's roughness coefficient, r is hydraulic mean radius, that is given by wetted area divided by wetted perimeter, and S naught is the bed slope. Again, I want the discharge. So Q is equal to A into V. So in place of V, if you substitute Manning's formula, you are going to get Q is equal to A into V, R that is equal to A divided by N into S raised to half R raised to 2/3. Now Q is in meter cube per second, velocity is in meter per second, hydraulic mean radius in meters, and bed slope is meter per meter, and Manning's roughness coefficient is a dimensionless number. Okay, so whenever we are talking about a uniform flow, either you can use Chase's formula or either you can use Manning's formula in order to find the velocity and the discharge in a channel carrying uniform flow. This is about the derivation of uniform flow for Chase's formula as well as for Manning's formula. Now, to give a flavor of this Manning's roughness coefficient for different surfaces, so I picked it from Google. Okay, so it will give a rough idea what is the value of n for different surfaces. For example, if you talk about smooth steel surface, the value of n is equal to 0.012. Similarly, for different metals, I mentioned about the value of n. Now, let us solve one or two problems on this Chase's formula and Manning's formula. for different cross sections, then we'll move further. The first problem goes like this. An open channel having a bed width of 3 meters and the depth of flow equal to 1.5 meter as shown in the figure. If the bed slope of the channel is 1 in 5000, find the rate of flow using Manning's equation. Take Manning's roughness coefficient n is as 0.025. So the first thing you need to do is write the neat sketch. So in this case, sketch is given. So the base width of the channel is 3 meters and the slide slopes is for every 2 horizontal there is 1 vertical. In this case, my value of n is equal to 2 and the depth of flow in the channel is 1.5 meter. Now first write Manning's equation. So what is Manning's equation? V is equal to 1 over n s to the power of half r to the power of 2/3. Now first we need to find the value of r. So r is given by a divided by p, where a is the wetted area, p is the wetted perimeter. Thus this is the trapezoidal section. For this trapezoidal section, the wetted area equation is given by b plus ny into y. What is the value of b? B is 3 meters. What is the value of n? From the figure, the value of n is equal to 2. Substitute the values. Therefore, wetted area A is equal to 3 plus 2 into the depth of flow is 1.5 into 1.5. So if you simplify this, you are going to get wetted area as 9 meter square. Now we'll calculate the wetted perimeter. Wetted perimeter equation is P is equal to B plus 2y into root of n square plus 1. Again, B is 3 meters plus 2 into 1.5 into root of. So n is 2, therefore 2 square plus 1 whole thing under root. So that becomes 3 plus 3 into root of 5. That simplifies to 9.71 meter. You know the value of R, A, you know the value of P. Substitute these values in that R equation and find the value of R. So R is equal to 9 divided by 9.71, that simplifies to 0.927 or 93 meter. Now consider the Manning's formula. 1 over n s to the power of half r to the power of 2/3. Manning's roughness coefficient is given in the problem, 0.025. Just now you calculated the value of r, that works out to be 0.2927. Substitute the value into the bed slope is given as 1 in 5000. So substitute these values and simplify. If you simplify that, we are going to get the value of v is equal to 0.54 meter per second. So once you get the value of v, you need to find the value of q. Q is equal to a into v. So what is a? A is 9 meter square. Therefore 9 into 0.538. Therefore the discharge in the channel is given by 4.84 meter cube per second. It's a very simple problem. This is how you are going to solve a problem for this trapezoidal section based on this Manning's formula. Okay, we'll move further. Problem goes like this. The cross section of an open channel is a trapezoid with a bottom width of 4 meter and side slopes 1:2. Calculate the discharge if the depth of water is 1.5 meter and bed slope is 1 over 1600. Take Chase's constant C is equal to 50. Okay, so this is similar to the earlier problem. Only difference between the earlier problem and this problem is In the earlier problem, we make use of Mannich's formula because Mannich's roughness coefficient is given there. Now in this case, you need to use Chase's formula because Chase's constant is given. Okay, I didn't solve this problem. You try to solve this problem. I'll go one step further. Problem goes like this. Open channel as shown. Bed slope is 69:1594. Find the rate of flow using the Chase's constant. Take Chase's constant C is equal to 35. Now if you look at this figure, the moment you see this figure, this is the irregular figure. Okay, don't be panic. So what we are going to do in this case is, we are going to divide this irregular figure into number of sections, regular figures. So once you divide this irregular figure into regular figures, go on finding the area, wetted area for each and every regular figure. And if you sum up this wetted area for all the regular figures, you are going to get the total wetted area for this irregular figure. That is right now what I did for this problem. Now, Chase's formula is given by V is equal to C into root of R into S naught. Now we'll start with A because you want the value for R is equal to A divided by P. Now what is wetted perimeter? You are starting from one end. You just go on measuring the length of that side. Starting from one end to other end, you are going to get the perimeter. I'll come to that little later. First, let us calculate the wetted area. Now, 2.52 into 5.04. Now I started from this side, okay, from the left hand side. So the vertical height is 2.54. So the horizontal width is 5.04. It's a triangle divided by 2. I am going to get the area of this triangle plus 2.52 into, it's a rectangle, second one is a rectangle, it is 16.8. So if we just go on doing this, finding the area of this regular figures and adding up the wetted area of all these regular figures, you are going to get A is equal to 162.52 meter square. Now you know the value of A. Now you need to find the value of P. So in order to find the value of P, okay, if you start from left hand side, you need the diagonal side, the length of the diagonal side. The length of the diagonal side you don't know, but you know in the triangle the vertical height and the horizontal height. Therefore, the diagonal side is given by 2.52 square plus 5.04 square, whole thing under root, plus 16.8. Again, you do the same procedure. It is 1.8 square plus 3.6 square, whole thing under root. You are going to get the diagonal length for the second small triangle plus 150 plus the vertical height is 0.72. You are starting either from the left hand side or from the right hand side. You just go on finding the perimeter. So perimeter works out to be 177.18. So now you have a value of A, you have a value of P. Find the value of R. R is equal to A divided by P. So A works out to be 162.52 and P is 177.18. Therefore, R simplifies to 0.92 meter. So once you get the value of R, consider the Chase's formula. V is equal to C into root of RS. So value of C given in the problem has 35 into root of So R is 0.92 into S naught is 69 divided by 15984. So if you simplify, there is a typo there, it is 69, so not 0.69. 69 divided by 1584 into 0.92 whole thing under root into 35, it simplifies to 0.7 meter per second. Now once you get the value of V, you need to find the value of Q. So Q is equal to A into V. So what is A? A is 162.52. 162.52 into 0.7, that simplifies to Q is equal to 1138.84 meter cube per second. So this is how you are going to apply Chase's formula and Manning's formula in order to calculate the discharge in a channel having uniform flow.